If you don't like this true Islam, you are simply telling me you have a problem with the Islam of Muhammad, Islam of the first four caliphs, rightly guided caliphs. So you were surprised regarding seeing the different Arabic Qurans. You are surprised reading from Muslim scholars about the different Arabic Qurans. You were surprised to hear about the adult breast suckling, and now you are surprised to hear on people can rape the people in front of their husbands who are non-believers.
I always heard about, you know, distortion, and you know, I heard about like distorted version of Islam, and now you showed me all of that because I never believed that there is.
Give me your version of Islam, because your version of Islam has nothing to do with the real Islam, what Islamic sources are teaching, okay? So give me your version of Islam.
My version of Islam, like whenever there was wars, you should not kill elderly people, women, you should not rape them, you should not do any harm, you should not do any harm for trees, for animals, for properties,
can you give me reference? It's not about being scholar. So
I'm telling you the Islam that I know, that I've been taught.
Do you think? So I'm Christian. I believe Lord Jesus Christ is the eternal Son of God who died on the cross for the sin of mankind. Okay? So my version of Christianity, okay? Jesus Christ is the eternal Son of God. I believe in triune God, God the Father, God the Son, and God the Spirit. And I believe Lord Jesus Christ died on the cross for the sin of mankind. If on the war, okay, in the war, do you think what will happen to me? Let's say Islam took over Britain. What will happen to me with my belief?
I know that when they took over some countries, so for example, they took, you know, the power there, and then they imposed the roles, and then everybody that different from Muslim has options either to be Muslim or to be as they are and worship whatever they want, but they need to pay jizya, which is like tax, sort of tax, which was actually less than what the Muslim is paying as zakat. And they've been, they have the right to worship and do whatever they want, and they have the right, you know, to do whatever they want without being...
So if Islam takes over the Britain, I will be given the full rights I have. Only extra thing I will be doing is giving the government money to protect me. Is that what you are saying?
Like what the others will pay as well. So
okay.
You're not only one of them.
Okay. So, can you bring up the reference for me? Because Islam takes over Britain or doesn't take over Britain, I will never convert to Islam. It is very dangerous ideology. So I will stay, and by grace of God, I will die as a lover of Lord Jesus Christ. And so far, let me finish.
Nobody will force you. Okay,
we will see the references for that. So
references Quran, like Rafatin, there is no compulsory in the religion. Which
okay,
means,
can you give me the reference for that?
Like Rafatin. It is there, like Rafatin, no compulsory.
So there is no compulsion in religion.
Whoever you want to believe, you do. Whoever you want to be, not believe in, you do.
So your belief is to you, my belief is to me.
Yeah, exactly, yeah. So it's never been the case that anybody forced anybody to Islam. This will never happen. According to the true Islam that I know. Now, there is practices of Muslims. There is big difference between the true Islam and what perverted or distorted Muslims are practicing. Just think about that very carefully. Because there's lots of Muslims who are doing things by the name of Islam which don't represent the true Islam.
So I'll read you a couple of things, okay? So you expressed, if Islam takes over Britain, okay, I expressed, by grace of my Lord, I will never convert to Islam, okay? And you told I can practice my religion.
You can.
Can I build a church?
You can.
I can. Can I do evangelism? Which means, can I go and then tell people about how glorious my God is?
Whatever you want.
I can do whatever
I want. According to the true Islam, I know.
According to Islam, you know.
According to the practices of Muslim, when some of them have done that, maybe not. Yeah. Okay. But the Islam will never force you to not worship or do anything. You are free to do whatever you want.
Okay. Can
I guarantee you?
So you guarantee me that?
Yeah. And it's been true Islam now. Not the like give me a story of somebody who has done something.
I'm very much disappointed that you are guaranteeing me things which Islam can't even guarantee me. So when Muslims conquered the Spain, okay, Christians in Spain, they were not allowed to build the mosques, build the churches, okay? They were discriminated and they were dehumanized. That's historical evidence. I can read the articles to you. Let me finish. I can read the articles to you again and again. So that's in the history. At the time of Muhammad, okay? What happened to the Banu Qurayza when Muhammad conquered Banu Qurayza?
The Jews, you mean?
Yeah.
My understanding, again, I'm not scholar. I know that there's been like treaty between them and they betrayed
them. No. I'm not asking why he conquered. I'm asking what happened to the people when Muhammad conquered.
According to the true Islam that I know, that they've been living peacefully, they went worshipping, they were doing whatever they want. They weren't even paying jizya because there was no jizya.
What is the reference for them?
I don't have like reference. I'm gonna pull up. I don't
you,
have.
You are, but you, I, you is, are the man who you know, speaks without reference. No, so I'll no, tell you. I'll tell you according to Islamic sources. How many people were killed?
Well, there is lots of wars between
900, approximately 900 Jews were killed. That doesn't look like.
And how many Muslims are killed?
Let me finish. Yeah. It's the Muslims who are conquering. Okay, so that doesn't look like to me. Jews can do whatever they want. That's the first point. Second point is, what happened to the women in that? When they killed the men, what happened to the women?
I think they have married them. I understand, but
married
not,
to whom?
Not against their will.
Married to whom?
To Muslims, for example.
Married to Muslims. Okay.
Not against their will.
Okay, Mr. Sir, what's your name? Jimmy. I'll ask you a basic question. Okay. What do you think? Are you listening, sir?
Yeah.
I love to get your opinion as well.
Yeah.
What do you think? When is it acceptable that your mom's, your father has been killed? Okay. Now your mom is dead. Your father has been killed. Your mom is dead. Do you think your mom, when she sees her family has been killed, suddenly fall in love with the Muslims kill her family?
No, she will never.
She will never. Yeah. Okay, she will never.
Yeah. And nobody forced her to love anybody.
Yeah.
She doesn't.
Okay. So that's according to you. Is that according to Islam? When Muhammad conquered Banu Qurayza, that Muhammad married the woman, okay, whom he killed all of her family. That day, Muhammad took her in her tent, and without any shame, he had a sex with her. And you think that's not rubbish. Muhammad is rubbish.
Muhammad will never do that.
Muhammad never
they
did that.
Never do that.
According to biography
according,
of Muhammad, Muhammad did that.
30 years of knowing Muhammad and what he taught and what I've been taught by different.
I'm afraid to tell you,
that's
you've been lied.
Rubbish, no.
You've been lied and you've been brainwashed.
No.
So.
He will never do that.
Sophia is
against it's against of his teaching. It doesn't make sense at all. The one that
which teaching? Like you were
merciful.
Muhammad never taught compassion and merciful. That is in your mind, not according to Islam.
Give me
the reference. Your true Islam goes against all of Islam, goes against Quran, goes against Muhammad, goes against all of the Sahih Hadith.
Muslims are going against those, you know, teachings and things. But you need to distinguish between the belief and faith that's being taught, the authentic one, and the one that people.
I'm making a distinction.
Islam will never do that. But Muslims
with the Quran, biography of Muhammad and the reliable Hadiths versus what they teach versus Muslims. Okay.
Yeah, Muslims,
do you think apostates should be killed?
What do you mean apostates, sorry?
Apostates is like I left Islam, I become a Christian.
No,
do you think
no,
I should be killed?
They shouldn't be killed because the Quran said that the one who wanna believe is up to them and the one they don't believe it's up to them. So they have to do whatever they want.
Then why Muhammad says kill those who live the religion of Islam?
There is lots of things about this that lots of scholars rejected that and lots of them supported that and said this is like weak hadith, is not so like supported
it
by...
It is Sahih hadith and it has been practiced in lots of Muslim countries.
So if you change your religion, like, you know...
You should be killed according to Islam.
I tell you,
But those are the most reliable hadiths, and then you are going against the Quran. Like, from this conversation, all I am thinking is right now you are not Muslim. You wouldn't survive at Speaker's Corner, because Muslims would identify you as a kafir, you discredit, and then you brought your own version of Islam.
That's not the version. The version, I absorbed everything, and I'm not religious, first of all. I'm not, practicing.
That's why you've been told lies.
I absorbed everything from
everybody. So your mother has told you lies. People who taught you about Islam, they told you lies. You've been told lies and lies and lies. So the way, one of the way we can move forward this conversation is, you said you will come back, okay? Would you mind writing down the points I made in case you forget? And then we pick it up from that next week with the references.
I will look at it, although I'm not very into searching.
But those things are important. I'm not talking about, how is butterfly, which flowers you like, do you like buttercup? Do you like daisies? I am talking about the things which affects our eternity. Okay? And so far what you said, according to Islamic teachings, you are identified as a hypocrite who should be killed. According to Islamic teachings, because you simply went against Muhammad. But according to me as a Christian, makes me more concerned. Actually, you are seriously in the wrong path. It's not because you don't follow Islam as it teaches, but you are not even sure where you are. And according to my scripture, there is only one way to God the Father, and that's Lord Jesus Christ. And you are already discrediting that. Let me ask you a question.
I'm not religious, I'm not practicing, but I feel comfortable with the teaching of Islam, the true faith, because it teaches really for, all what you see in practice, the Muslims are practicing is really rubbish. And they are misrepresenting Islam, and people think that this is Islam, but this is not. This is either perverted Muslims that they're doing, horrible, horrendous things that nobody endures, or either they are misunderstanding Islam, or either they are in purpose doing that. But the true Islam will never make you feel other than peaceful and be peaceful to everybody, not harming anybody.
True Islam will never give me right to breathe in and breathe out.
Come on.
True Islam discredits me. Are you aware? Your book. Are you aware? Your book calls me the worst of creatures. Calls me, because of my belief, I am the worst of creatures.
No, not at all.
Okay.
I can show you, in the Quran. I don't know exactly again where is it.
I'll show it to you. I'll put it very simple.
Yeah, it says the closest one to Christians, the Muslims are the Christians who have their beers, priests, and etc., which
indeed they who disbelieve among the people of the scripture and the polytheists will be in hell, in fire of hell, abounding eternally therein. There are the worst of creatures.
Is it
Surah 98 verse 6. I am the people of the book. I am Christian.
Yeah.
And your Quran identifies me as the people of the book. I am the worst of creatures.
Yeah.
Do you think I look like you don't even know what is my favorite color?
No.
You don't even know what is my favorite food. But are you quite okay
say,
that your book
something.
Identifies
yeah.
me because of my belief I am the worst of creatures?
Something. This is actually something that we need to, all the religions need to look at really very unbiasedly. That every religion thinks that the other religion would be in fire and they are the ones who are going to be in heaven. So I think Christians as well think that people who never believe in Christ, that would be in hell. And Muslims the same, and Jews as well, that believe if you don't believe in our God, then you are at hell.
That's very much different. Then because of my belief, I just met this gentleman, and there is no way I can say he's the worst of creatures.
No,
if you think about, does he look worse than rat? Does he look worse than cockroach? Does he look worse than dog? Dogs are actually very beautiful.
Well.
Yeah. So now, do I look like worse than cockroach? No. Do I look like worse than rat? No. Do I look like worse than? Allah says that.
No,
it is good that no one agrees with Allah. That's very good. But Allah says
Allah never said that. I think
Allah said that. Allah already said that, and then I read it to you.
So Allah created the everything.
Allah created everything, but Allah called me worst of creatures.
No, you created you as well. According to my belief, He created everything. So and then He sent messenger to, tell about His message, and then He sent things that rewards if you are in line with what He said and if you are submissive to his will, for example, and teaching. And then he's also sent like warnings, and like if you don't believe it, that then there would be like hell and everything.
That's different than being called worst of creatures. That's very much different.
Worst of creatures.
Okay.
Worst of creatures.
Worst of creatures.
No, I never heard. What's in Arabic? What's in Arabic?
Those are the worst of creatures.
What's in Arabic?
You are the Arabic speaker.
Yeah.
Turn to Surah 98, verse 6.
Do you know what's the name of the surah? I don't know the numbers.
Bayina.
Huh?
Al-Bayina. And then after that, I would love to...
Al-Bayina?
I would love to get your version of Islam on the place of woman. It's towards the end.
Yeah.
Have you found it?
No.
Verse 6.
Yeah, he's saying that those who disbelieve, and you know, as I told you, you know, the ones that who don't believe, they will be in hell, and this is what again.
Does it call me worst of creatures or it doesn't?
It does.
It does call me. So, your Islam disagree. So you don't call me, but Allah calls me. That's absolutely fine.
Yeah.
Allah doesn't know what is my favorite color. Allah doesn't know what is my favorite flower. Allah doesn't know what is my favorite food. But Allah still calls me worst of creatures.
Because I think to Allah, my understanding, then if because He gives you everything. Again, according to Muslims, and I think you are as Christian as well, you would say that Jesus gives you everything, and if you don't believe in it, you're...
That's
like
two
mental.
Different things. No, that's two different things.
That's
two different things.
And there's also verses in Quran that say that people who don't understand and don't believe, after all what I've given them, that they are really mental or whatever, I don't know what the words, but
so,
according to the, you know...
Believing Lord Jesus Christ is the only one way to Father is very much different than calling individuals because of their belief as the worst of creatures are two different things. But let me hear your version of Islam.
Okay? About woman?
About woman. Is that okay?
So woman, sure. What do you want to know?
So, did your father beat your mom?
No.
No. Okay. What would you say if someone beats his wife?
He's an ugly person and he needs to be prosecuted.
He's ugly, needs to be prosecuted.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah, I know what you're going to bring up right now, but like... I know.
Let me read it.
Yeah, I know.
And then we call Allah and Muhammad ugly and needs to be prosecuted.
Definitely, but you know,
definitely.
Again,
okay.
You need...
Definitely Allah needs to be called
no,
ugly and prosecuted.
According to your version, yes, definitely. But according to true Islam, it's not.
Okay, I read the Quranic verse to you, and then you give me the... You translate it for me.
So this is like Udribuhunna, which is like beat them. And it's been confirmed.
Okay, just a moment. Does the verse say beat them?
It does say beat them.
Beat
exactly.
them, okay. So,
exactly.
Does the verse say wife is beating the husband or husband is beating
the
wife?
No, husband beating the wife.
Husband is beating the wife.
And I'll tell you what.
Just a moment. How would you feel, sir? How would you feel if you are beating your wife? Would you beat your wife? He wouldn't. How would you feel when your father is beating your mom? He would be very upset.
Can I
turn.
Explain?
So,
for
so
example,
it is not
explain?
The wife who is beating, it is the husband who is
husband
beating.
Husband is beating wife. And
husband
I'll
is the
I'll
beating
give you my
wife.
Understanding
okay.
to, which is according to true Islam. So when the prayer for Muslim, you know, Allah said that you need to pray, He didn't prescribe in the Quran how you're going to pray. Muhammad practiced that, so we learned from Muhammad how to pray and go up and down and everything, right? So when He said that, Jubuhum, which is beat them, husbands beat wife, it's been explained by Muhammad that you need to do like with like a miswak, which is like small like wood that's been used for cleaning the teeth, like just do a tap on it. This is how it's been explained.
And according to whom?
According to Muhammad, according
what
to
is
the whole Islamic. According to Muhammad, according to the Islamic.
I'll give you according to realist, according to Islam of Muhammad.
Saying, like, beat them.
No, let me give you. So there is a story.
It's like.
Listen, I'm going to give you the references, okay? There is a story. This woman has been beaten. Her skin is greener than her dress.
Yeah.
Okay? What would you say if your skin is greener than your dress?
This is ugly.
So that is a bruise. You've been abused, you've been beaten,
ugly.
Now
exactly.
You've got the bruise. Okay?
Exactly, yeah.
They go to Muhammad, and then She says, he beats me. This is the evidence. And then Mohammed says, oh, why did he beat you? All blah, blah, blah conversation. Mohammed sends this woman back to her husband and then says, oh, no, you cannot get divorced from this gentleman until he have sex with you. Mohammed doesn't turn to the... I'll show it to you. I'm going to show it to you. Mohammed doesn't turn to the woman.
He's bringing up a lot of sex when you talk about Mohammed, which he's not into that. He's not as much as it's...
Actually, no, Mohammed was like sex colleague, but I'll give you the reference on that. Let me first finish the woman part. Mohammed doesn't turn to the woman and then say, oh, I'm sorry, woman. What happened to your leg? That's so green. Is that bruise? Did you put toothpaste on it? Did you put cream on it? Mohammed doesn't do that. Mohammed sends her back to her husband who abused her. That's the first. That's the first one. Second one. Mohammed beats his wife Aisha from her chest, which causes strikes her on chest, which causes her pain. Okay, those are the two examples.
I can assure you that I never.
Let me read it to you. Sahih Muslim, 21:27 is the hadith reference, but I'm going to read it to you.
I'm surprised so far by the your own version of Islam, which is
My version of Islam is Sahih Bukhari, Sahih Muslim, and Muhammad version of Islam. And I am grateful that you think it is wrong. Definitely to abuse the woman. It is just disgraceful. Allah, with all of his wisdom, he thinks it's okay.
99 of the Muslims will say the same. They will say that they are against...
Let me read it to you. Are you ready?
I am.
I'm going to read it to you.
Can I take a break and come back to you? Because
I read it to you and then you take a break after that, okay? I'm not sure why would you take a break while we are talking about beautiful Islam.
No, please don't. I mean, make it like constructive talking, not like mockery, you know.
Your Islam just disagrees with you, and then I'm going to give it to you more, no. Okay? So, this is the
it's
one.
Just only in your
Sahih
mind,
Bukhari.
Honestly, it seems just only in your mind, but in reality...
Look. If I take off my glasses, I can't see, okay? I am reading with my glasses, and with my glasses it says Sahih al-Bukhari, yeah. 772-715. Okay, this is the copy and paste. You can simply read it from own sources. Narrated Ikrimah. Riva is divorced wife, whereupon Abdurrahman bin Azara, blah, 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 okay, married to her. Aisha said to the lady came, wearing a veil and comparing her of her husband and shoved a green spot in her skin by beating, caused by beating. She's got a green spot in her skin, which is caused by beating. It was the habit of the ladies to support each other. So when Allah's apostle came, Aisha said, I have not seen any woman suffering as much as the believing woman. There are billions of women around me, but I never seen anyone is suffering as Muslim woman. Okay? Look, her skin is greener than her clothes. When Abdurrahman heard that his wife had gone to the Prophet, he came with his two sons from another wife. She said, by Allah, I have done no wrong to him, but he is impotent and is as useless to me as this, holding and shoving the fringe of her garment. Abdurrahman said, by Allah, O Allah's apostle, she had told a lie. I am very strong and I can satisfy her. But she is disobedient and wants to go back to Rifa. Allah's apostle said to her, so she's got a bruise, okay? She wants to go back to she wants to marry with someone else, okay? That bruise has been caused by beating, this is what Muhammad says. If that is your intention, then you know it is unlawful for you to remarry Rifa unless Abdurrahman had a sexual intercourse with you. Then the Prophet saw the two boys and then it goes on. So Muhammad didn't turn to woman and then said, I'm sorry for the bruises.
You're gone. So they're coming to him to judge, you know, and maybe, I don't know, to make reconcile with them, and he's recommending sex for them. I mean, come on, this is not like Muhammad, I know. This is your Muhammad.
This is Sahih Bukhari's Muhammad. This is Sahih Bukhari's Muhammad.
Anyways, I respect, you know.
Okay, go and take 5 minutes break and then come back.
Yeah, well,
but I will keep you accountable for the follow-up things, okay? The ones, for example, Aisha is beating.
I mean, you need to be just really, not, I mean, I really respect what you're saying and everything, but you need to be like, you know, I mean, we need to talk about the good things between religions rather than what's
but there is nothing good in Islam, I can tell you. I already told you how disturbing it is. It's not.
It is disturbing.
Muslims and Islam is different thing. You are Muslim.
Disturbing.
My God made you in His image. He loves you. But Islam, your ideology, the references I read you, they are very much disturbing. And my prayer is that Lord Jesus Christ, our glorious God, our glorious gospel, will go to each house, each Muslim house, and transform those individuals who live in these houses. That's my hope and my prayer. But Islam will be destroyed by my glorious gospel. And this Islam is very dangerous, like smoking. Can you see what it says? Smoking kills. Smoking causes cancer.
This version of Islam in your mind is really cancerous. I would say that. Yeah, I would agree. But the true Islam.
Okay,
is not...
so sorry, you agree that the version of Islam I read to you is like cancer.
I agree that you have, like, I guess your own idea about Islam, which is completely wrong. And I'm agreed. I'm sure that, you know, everything that you said that has like explanation with it. I never seen.
What,
you know,
kind of explanation?
Like,
what kind
example,
of justification,
you know, when I was kid,
can be there to give bruises to your wife?
No, when I was kid,
what
for
kind of justification can be there to be called me worst of creatures? What kind of justification can be there that Allah ordering strangers to come and suck your breast? What kind of justification?
When I was scared, you know, when I was used to go to mosque and hear the imams saying about things, I remember very well that they told me that beating the wives are not allowed in Islam. They told me to take care of neighbors. They told me not to.
You've been lied. Your imams lie to you.
The of breasts,
your imams lie to you. It's not funny.
Yeah.
Your imams lie to you. Your mom, people who taught you. Islam is lie to you. It is Allah says suck their breasts.
Other religions, other
it is
people,
Allah.
And
yeah, but that's what Islam teaches. So you've been lied to.
Yeah, you told me to be kind for non-Muslims. You need to be kind for the neighbors, for everybody, take care of them, blah, blah, blah. So you tell me all those good values.
You've been lied to, and I'm here to tell you that you've been lied to. Because Islam allows lying, and then they brainwashed you.
Okay, I'm gonna smoke now.
Okay, go and smoke. Remember, smoke kills. I find it's very strange that individuals see the different Arabic Qurans, individuals see the teachings of the Islam regarding the adult breast suckling, regarding be to be called worst of creatures from their own sources, regarding from their own sources wife beating, and still they want to follow the version which they have been lied for centuries and for centuries. That is very much disturbing. That is very much disturbing. But good news is, our glorious Lamb of God, our glorious King of Kings, our glorious eternal Son of God did something for humanity to shake them up. He gave Himself for humanity. And in that humanity, even though that ideology calls me the worst of creatures, in that humanity, Muslim people are in that humanity. My glorious God, my glorious and awesome and delightful God, gave Himself for Muslim people. And with His own grace, He's going to touch in every heart of Muslims, the children's, adult, elders, imams, sheikhs, the Muslims who have been lied. And one day, they will all bow down to Lord Jesus Christ, because they will know Islam gives no solution to humanity. Islam gives no solution to individuals, let alone Islam doesn't even give God to them. If anyone wants to have peace, then only peace you can have with yourself, with your neighbor, and with God is only from the Prince of Peace, Lord Jesus Christ.